volunteer journalist has a bucket list of dream stories. Karen, check. Tony Veach's wellness retreat, what the fuck is going on there? And John Owen Casford, a man who made international headlines when he broke into Wellington Zoo to steal a monkey. The monkey escaped, but John was caught and sentenced to 3 years in jail. What could possibly drive a person to try and steal a monkey from the zoo? For 3 years, it's been my dream to meet John and ask him that question. And today, my dream comes true.
I have been waiting for this moment for fucking 3 years.
Imagine how I feel, man. I've been locked up for 3 years.
Yeah. Straight to the strip club, is it?
Yeah, sounds good.
We're not going to a strip club. Okay, you're in the prison yard. Everyone's having a chat, talking about why they're in jail. First guy goes murder.
Yeah.
Second guy goes aggravated robbery.
Yeah.
And it comes to you.
Yeah.
And what do you say?
Stole a monkey from Wellington Zoo. They're like, yeah, yeah, good cunt, out of it cunt. At least I didn't murder or rape someone, you know?
Yeah, that's really positive,
Yeah.
John was finally home, and his mates were waiting with a surprise barbecue.
You're right.
A glass barbecue.
So what did you think when you tried to break into the Wellington Zoo?
Fucking what a good cunt.
Yeah, when he was robbing that monkey, all I was doing was listening to my Will Smith CD.
So you were just having a great time getting jiggy with it?
And he's trying to catch this monkey.
Any happy memories about
When he shin kicked me in the face. Good cunt.
One of your good memories with John was when he shin kicked you in the face.
Yeah, because he's my boy. Yeah.
John's boys had a lot of great memories, but there was only one memory that I was interested in. A story that I'd been waiting for 3 years.
What drives a man to the point where he's breaking into Wellington Zoo to steal a monkey?
Love.
So it began when you were on a date with your girlfriend at the zoo?
Yeah, and this little monkey come up and stuck its little paw up on the window against her hand, like something out of a movie. She said, oh my God, I want one of those. And I thought, fuck, that's what I'm gonna get her. I'm gonna go get her that monkey. Next thing, climbed in there and went and got it. 2 a.m.
Can't be easy to catch a monkey.
I was too scared to stick my arm in there and just reach around, you know? So I like lit the lighter, flick, 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 and I just seen his little eyes look at him and grabbed it and shoved it into my bag and then left. I make it to the fence and it's all electrified on the top. And I was like, all right, I'll climb that, I'll get to the top and I'll sort of push myself up and jump off to the grass.
So that was the plan?
Yeah.
How'd that go?
Yeah, it went real bad, yeah. I had the monkey in one hand and then I got too close to the electrified fence and I panicked and I got my foot on and then I let go of the monkey in that and I jumped, like pushed myself off, and then I missed my landing area and then I fell like 8-9 meters into a big concrete running track.
Okay.
Blew all my teeth out, broke my leg.
So when you said you blew all your teeth out...
Yeah, teeth gone. Yeah.
So you fell like feet and then face?
On my feet, but the force of it was just like headbutt the ground. Like, it was the meanest ground shock ever.
So you go like an 8 meter drop?
Yeah.
And you get the meanest ground shock ever?
It was still my teeth that smashed the ground.
If it wasn't for your teeth, that would have been a serious injury.
I'm starting to think at this point it's not a good idea. I went to stand uphill and my whole leg in the middle just folded. So I just sat down and then running the ambulance, fixed my teeth, put my leg in a cast. I catch up with my missus, she's like, oh, you dumb child.
Wait, so now you're like, time to go for a date with the missus?
Yeah, like, I didn't see her in a couple of days, yeah. It was her birthday the next day, so we're going shopping and, you know. I seen a police car drive past, and I just turned and, like, started walking. I was like, babe, the police started, like, running, and then, like...
On one leg?
Yeah, he just come running up behind me. Mate, you're under arrest, we've been looking for you for ages. With her screaming in the background as I'm getting dragged out, leave him alone, he's got a broken leg.
You do a real good impersonation of your missus, by the way. I'm sure she'll love to see this.
Probably.
She'll be like, great job, John, you really nailed my voice, mate. You're there in a jail cell, you got a broken leg.
Mm.
What were you feeling? What were you thinking?
Ratchet. But I was relieved at the same time.
Ratchet? It must be more than ratchet. You're like, I fucked everything.
Bit of relief too, you know, like, right, now we can deal with all of this, you know?
Get your life back on track.
Yeah, exactly.
I guess the only question I have left is, did you get your girlfriend a present?
No, I ended up going to jail for 3 years on her birthday. So, you know.
Are you guys still together?
Nah, but, you know, you never know what the future holds. Doing it right now, you know. And she's seeing that, so she's happy.
Do you still love her?
Yeah, fucking oath. Always.
It's almost like a beautiful rom-com.
Yeah.
Almost.
Yeah, almost.
Almost.
John's story was one of breaking and entering, animal abuse, and serious head trauma.
You shin kicked me in the face. Good cunt.
But if you ignore all that, you're left with a classic romantic comedy. A romantic comedy that didn't have an ending. Yet. We needed the female lead. The person that he tried to steal the monkey for, John's ex-girlfriend, Melissa.
For New Zealand Today, it's a light entertainment program.
No, thank you.
Okay.
Who didn't sign a release form, so we'll now refer to as Sarah. I realised that in order to win back the girl, John was going to have to prove that he'd changed. And in order to do that, he had an apology to make.
I hope from the bottom of my heart you can accept my apology.
More accurately, I had an apology to make because John's not allowed back at the zoo.
Dear monkey, sorry for abducting you at 3 in the morning as a gift for my missus. No hard feelings. You're welcome to come through. Sorry, I was just reading an apology to a monkey.
With the monkey's forgiveness, it was time to make a plan.
This whole thing happened because you were a romantic.
Pretty much.
We need to like kind of make it up to her.
Yeah.
We need a grand romantic gesture. You gotta go big.
It doesn't matter if I go big or, all right, I love you on a bit of card.
That's beautiful,
you know?
But a card is not gonna cut it.
Steal it into Island of Fairy and run it up on the beach. With I love you and a big banner across the front of it.
That's not a bad idea. There you go, now we're thinking.
Stand in the middle of town naked with a sign saying I love you.
You know that's a crime, right?
Probably.
Like, yeah. You'll get arrested for that. Yeah. Then we're back to fucking jail, we're back to square one, aren't we?
Back to square one, yeah.
What a woman love. Woman's rights.
My missus is real big into that at the moment.
Woman's weekly.
Romantic comedies.
Yes. Yeah. So tell me this, what's your favourite romantic comedy?
I couldn't tell you.
We just need to find that out.
Find that right now.
The plan was perfect. John was going to reenact the most famous scene from his ex-girlfriend's favourite movie.
10 Things I Hate About You.
Sounds familiar. Adam Sandler?
There's no Adam Sandler. You must. 10 Things I Hate About You. He's a bad boy, she's a good girl kind of thing. It almost like works with your relationship perfectly.
Maybe, yeah.
Heath Ledger's famous solo scene was the grand gesture we'd been looking for. There was only one problem. John can't sing. Yet.
This is a leading vocal coach here in Wellington.
Nice to meet you.
I don't want to say your relationship and your whole future is on the line, but there's a lot riding on this.
Yeah. I think if it were me, I'd want to give myself more than just one lesson to be able to prepare.
Maybe we do two lessons.
We can't afford two lessons.
Okay, so what we'd normally do is you warm up first.
Yep, vocal warm up.
Yep, can you just move your tongue in and out as fast as you can? Faster, 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 faster. That's just fun. We don't actually do that.
I enjoyed it.
Yeah. Missus would have enjoyed it too.
Yeah, boy! We're going to win the missus back first.
Yeah,
all right, all right.
Try this one, John. So, la, 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 la.
La, 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 la.
Nice. Out of those 8 notes, how many of them did he get?
The first one.
Well, one's better than none.
Yeah, one's better than none. All right, bro.
Started strong.
Yeah.
I think we're ready. Wish us luck.
Good luck.
John was ready. It was time to win back the girl he lost 3 years ago. It was a good day in Wellington, one of their 3 every year. There was cricket on at the Basin, and John's ex-girlfriend had just won 2 front row seats.
G'day, it's Damo here from More FM Wellington. How are you? Congratulations, mate. You've just won 2 tickets to the cricket. Yeah, no, today. Yeah, no, they're non-refundable. Well, I didn't tell you this, you've also won $100. You've just got to get on down to the Basin Reserve to pick it up.
It's Guy Williams here from New Zealand Today. Yeah, we'll pay you $600 if you come to the Basin Reserve today.
Let's not focus on how much we paid. What's important is the stage was set.
You a cricket fan?
Yep, definitely.
Who's your favourite team?
Black somethings.
The Black somethings. Beautiful. How are you feeling? You nervous?
A little bit nervous, but we got this.
I honestly don't think we do. John, I've known you for a couple of days now. You've been a great guy.
Yep.
And all I can say is it's time for you to
man,
do the business.
Mine.
Yeah, good luck, man.
Cheers, mate.
I have no idea what's going to happen, but I think it's going to be good.
John Casford has a dark past, but he claims he's a changed man. Now he's going to put it all on the line for the woman he loves.
Showtime.
I wanna hold
told you so much, and I thank love has arrived, and thank God I'm alive. You're too good to be true. I can't take my eyes off of you.
Come on, John. That was beautiful.
It was the perfect ending to a beautiful story. 3 years ago, John stole a monkey. Today, he stole a heart. Was John high when he tried to steal that monkey? Probably. Is he still high now? Definitely. But now he's high on the most powerful drug of all, true love. And some would say that love is all you need.